So viewers, as I am telling you, some result related to cardinal number of a set. If ABC is my three finite set, then U is be the universal set. Then n of a is equal to n of a prime is equal to n of u to n of a. Okay. Next, n of a union b is equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. Okay. Next, 3, n of a union b is equal to n of a plus n of b, where a and b are non-empty and disjoint. Disjoint set. Okay. Next, 4, n of a intersection b complement is equal to n of a minus n of a intersection b. 5, n of a complement intersection b complement is equal to n of a union b prime is equal to u minus n of a union b. 6, n of a complement union b complement is equal to n of a intersection b is equal to a intersection b complement is equal to n of u. N of u minus n of a intersection b. Next, 7, n of a minus b is equal to n of a minus n of a intersection b. 8, n of a intersection b is equal to n of a union b minus n of a intersection b complement minus n of a complement intersection b. Similarly, 'n' of a union b union c, what will be my result? If we compute that, 'n' of a union b union c, n of a union b union c is equal to n of a n of a plus n of b plus n of c minus n of a intersection b minus n of b intersection c minus n of c intersection a plus n of a intersection b intersection c. Okay. Similarly, this is 9. Similarly, for 10, if we take a1, a2, a3, dot dot dot, an, okay, our disjoint set, these are all disjoint, remind that, disjoint, otherwise this will not happen, disjoint set, then n of a1 union a2 union a3 dot 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 union an, that's equal to n of a1 plus n of a2 plus dot 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 n of an. For disjoint part, actually we are getting that for disjoint, the intersection part will be zero, because two sets are said to be disjoint if A intersection B is equal to phi. Now if A intersection B is equal to phi, then n of phi is equal to what? Zero. N of phi is equal to zero. That's why if the sets are disjoint, only the intersection parts should be vanish, and only the plus part, these parts will be remaining here. Now 11, n of a symmetric difference b is equal to number of element which belong to exactly one of a or b, is equal to number of element which exactly belong to one of a or b. It's clear. Next, come to Cartesian product of two set. What is Cartesian product of two set? If a and b two sets, then the Cartesian product is denoted by a cross b, and it can be written as a comma b, such that a belongs to a and b belongs to capital B. This is the Cartesian product of two sets. Okay, now one point that you have to remember, that a cross b is not equal to b cross a. Remember that. Okay, next, some tricks. Some tricks for problem solving. First trick is, if a is equal to phi or b is equal to phi, then a cross b is equal to phi. Tricks. If a is equal to phi or b is equal to phi, then a cross b is equal to phi. This is the first trick. Next, second trick. A has n element and b has m element. If a has n element and b has m element, okay, then a cross b has mn element. Third, if a1, a2, dot dot dot, an are non-empty sets, then their Cartesian product is defined as this sign, the product sign, n is equal to n is equal to 1 to 1 to sorry if a1 a2 a2 dot 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 ar I am taking ar, this is ar, okay, b r non-empty set, then the Cartesian product of this set is defined as r is equal to 1 to r is equal to or I is equal to Cartesian product defined as I is equal to 1 to r AI is equal to A1, A2, A3, dot dot dot, AR. Okay, where AI belongs to capital AI. For all I. This you have to remember. Now, there are some result related to Cartesian product. The first result is A cross B union C is equal to A cross B union A cross C. Second, A cross B intersection C is equal to A cross B intersection A cross C. Third, A cross B minus C is equal to A cross B minus A cross C. Next, fourth, A cross B intersection S cross T. Okay, that's equal to A intersection S cross B intersection T. Where S and T are two sets, where S and T are another two sets. Next, five, if A is a subset of B, then A cross C is a subset of B cross C. Next, six, if A is a subset of B, then A cross B intersection B cross A is equal to A square. Okay. Next, seven, if A is a subset of B and C is a subset of D, then A cross C is a subset of B cross D. You have to remember that. Next, eight, if A is a subset of B, then A cross A is a subset of A cross B cross B cross A. Next, nine, if A and B are two non-empty sets having n element in common, then A cross B and B cross A have n square element in common. A and B both have n element common. Then A cross B and B cross A, A cross B